Hello friends, I am Naval Yemul, working as an assistant professor in Mechanical Engineering Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video, we are going to study the introduction to Scilab part 1. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to explain different mathematical functions of Scilab software. Content: introduction to Scilab, MATLAB, we'll see what is free software, history of Scilab, how to download and install Scilab, references. Introduction to Scilab. Scilab is pronounced as Sci, that is scientific, and Lab, that is laboratory. Scilab is a free and open source cross-platform numerical computational package and a high-level numerically oriented programming language. Scilab is a free software alternative to MATLAB. It is free and open source software. Figure 1 shows the logo of the Scilab. MATLAB. MATLAB believed to be used by over a million users in industry and academic, appeared in late 1970s and has become a hot favorite of users who are either not skilled or simply uninterested in getting entangled with syntax of languages like C or Pascal, even to solve a simple problems. MATLAB is a numerical computing environment and fourth generation programming language. It is developed by the MathWorks. Among MATLAB's capabilities, the key is matrix manipulation. The name MATLAB itself is an acronym of matrix laboratory, handling of functions and data, implementation of algorithm, and creation of user interface. MATLAB is a proprietary software and a license fee is mandatory for its use. The free software movement attempts to offer technically, ethically superior and free alternative to proprietary softwares. There are many free open source alternatives to MATLAB. In particular, Scilab is very popular. So figure 2 shows you the window of the MATLAB. Free software. Wikipedia defines free software as follows: free software or software liberal is software that can be used, studied, and even modified without restriction, and which can be copied and redistributed in modified or unmodified form, either without any restrictions. Free software is available free of charge in most cases. It may be noted that there are currently alternative terms for free software, such as software liberal, free, and open source software, that is called FOSS. Scilab is free and open source software, that is called FOSS. A free software generally permits 4 kinds of freedom to its users: the freedom to run the software anywhere and any way, freedom to copy and distribute, the freedom to access to the source code of the software, the freedom to modify and redistribute. So we'll see what is the history of Scilab. In 80s, the CACSD, that is Computer Aided Control System Design software, was created at a IRIA in France. Then at the beginning of 90s, the software name changed to Scilab. It was then developed by the Scilab group, composed by 6 researchers from ENPC. Scilab 1.1, the first released version of Scilab, was put on site on January 2nd, 1994. Think. What is the necessity of Scilab? Why you should choose Scilab software? Think for a few seconds. Pause the video. Okay, let us see why it is necessary to use Scilab software. So the syntax of Scilab is very easy as compared to any other software like C and C++ or Java. Scilab is free software and it is easily available. Numerical problems can be expressed in a reduced number of code lines as compared to similar solution using traditional languages. There is a very large user community in Scilab that uses and supports Scilab by contributing in the form of mailing list, Usenet groups, that is internet discussion system, and there are websites. Sorry. Downloading and installing Scilab. It is very easy to download and install Scilab. So Scilab works and it is available for different platforms, such as it works on Windows platform and Linux and Mac. The home page of Scilab is www.scilab.org. So this is the home page of Scilab. Once you open the home page, click on download. There are various options which are available for Windows platform, Linux as well as Mac. You can click on that, your file gets downloaded, and just click on the downloaded file and run the file. The setup file will be installed in your PC or laptop. And that Scilab is ready to use. Excuse me. So after installing the Scilab window, it looks like this. So this is a freshly launched Scilab window. You can see the console window, and above the console window there is a file menu which is described in the next video. So let us see the simple calculations on Scilab. What we can do on Scilab is with this example you will clearly understand how simple the Scilab is. Suppose if we type x is equal to 5 and use semicolon followed by that, then followed by enter, then take y equal to 6, semicolon, then followed by enter. Here the value of 5 is assigned to x and value of 6 is assigned to 5. Then if we multiply 5 and 6, just we need to type x into or asterisk y, we get the result as 30. This operation is performed on the Scilab and the image of that is shown in the figure. So it's very simple. Just assign the value of x, assign the value of y, and the operation which we need, that is x into y, just type x into y, you'll get the answer. So we'll see what are the different operators that are frequently used and accepted in Scilab. Plus sign for addition, minus sign for subtraction, asterisk sign or multiplication sign for multiplication, then for division we use slash sign, and raise to, that is cap sign for power operations. So we have taken a few examples how we can use Scilab. So first we have taken addition operator, that is plus sign. 5.5 plus 3.75, the answer is 9.25. In the same way, we have taken a minus, that is subtraction operator. 6.0 minus 2.36, we get answer as 3.64. Just we need to type 6.0 minus 2.36, then press enter, you get the answer. In the same way, we use for multiplication, we use for division, and we use for power also. Very simple, just you need to type 2 raised to 6 and press enter, you will get the answer as 64. All these operations are found in the Scilab and it is shown in a screenshot. So all the operations are performed. It is very simple and very easy as compared to the traditional languages like C and C++. These are the references I have used. Thank you.